Covering the news of the day has always been the force that has driven WDSU-TV over the past 50 years. Our news coverage has won numerous awards for the station, and we trust won your confidence in Louisiana's first television station as a place to which you turn for authoritative news coverage. So let's turn back the clock to some of those major stories. The campus of Ole Miss in Oxford, Mississippi became a battleground in September of 1962. We have always taken our cameras wherever they needed to be to cover the news. And they were there throughout that long night when two people died in the riots that led to the admission of Ole Miss's first black student, James Meredith. We were in Little Rock, Arkansas, when President Eisenhower sent in federal troops to enforce school desegregation there. It's the kind of hard-hitting news coverage we have practiced over the last 50 years, winning numerous awards, including an Emmy for an undercover documentary on the Ku Klux Klan by reporter Bob Wagner, who was captured and beaten by them. As school integration was about to begin in New Orleans, and as mounting opposition threatened to disrupt our school system, we took our cameras to Prince Edward County in Virginia, to the little town of Front Royal, for an object lesson. The opposition there had led to a total shutdown of their school system. We took our cameras to Japan, New Orleans' leading world trade partner, and even beamed a live broadcast back to New Orleans.
Hello, New Orleans, from Tokyo.
Every Saints fan knows the voice of Jerry Romig, the Superdome announcer. He took a sentimental journey home to our old studios on Royal Street, where he had spent almost 20 years as a news reporter and station executive in the early years after WDSU was founded by philanthropist Edgar B. Stern, Jr.
We had a staff, as you well know, that would go anywhere and try anything. Coverage of Baton Rouge in the legislature. It was unheard of, cameras going into Baton Rouge and going into the state capitol. We pioneered that, absolutely. It was unheard of. But, gosh, we've been through some days.
And here in the 90s, we continued traveling the world to cover the news. We followed a contingent of New Orleans Marines into Operation Desert Storm, and later to Bosnia with a group of Louisiana peacekeepers. And in January of this year, we traveled to Cuba with a group of New Orleans pilgrims to cover the visit of Pope John Paul II to the island.
We have taken all of those trophies we have won over the years, including this Emmy, and put them on display here in our new building at Howard and Barone as a reminder of what we have done and been over the past 50 years as Louisiana's first television station, and what we plan to remain over the next 50 years, Louisiana's best television station.
Now, remember those pictures of federal troops in Little Rock, Arkansas? Today, we'd show it to you live in living color. But in 1957, it was not that easy for cameraman Mike Lalla, shooting black and white film, flying it back to New Orleans to the Pan American Film Laboratory.
You know, it's so easy to get our television news pictures these days with all this sophisticated electronic wizardry, our video and sound recording equipment, that it's hard to remember how difficult it was for this man, Mike Lalla, one of our original photographers at Channel 6. Almost 50 years ago, Mike, you had to do it all with one camera, didn't you?
We call a Bell and Howell DR-70 then, Alec.
A wind-up camera?
Wind-up camera, just like a clock.
And it gave you 2 minutes and 45 seconds of shooting time.
And this, right now, we think it's rather primitive, but at that time, we thought it was really sophisticated.
And the films came out of that camera, went to this place, Pan American Film Lab, and that took another hour.
Before we got it back, and then we had to get back to the studio, because we had no processing at the studio at the time.
Lalla retired from WDSU in the early 80s to open the old Nolan's Cookery on Contime, now one of the city's more popular restaurants. From news photographer to restaurateur, maybe quite a stretch, but the fact is, the cookery is now known all over America. We met Mike at the cookery to talk about the stories he covered with his little wind-up black-and-white camera, like the Ole Miss riots that left two people dead as the university enrolled its first black student.
It was rather frightening, tear gas and everything else going on. It was a rather exciting evening. I guess when you think about the adrenaline throw in, it was one of the most exciting stories I've ever covered.
Residents of the low-lying areas are...
And he remembers Hurricane Camille in 1969, which destroyed the Bay St. Louis Bridge, cutting off the Gulf Coast and leaving Lalla to come up with a creative way to get there and get the story.
Next morning, we got over to there. We couldn't cross the bridge, and I got a young man on a motorcycle to take me all the way into Gulfport because all the road was gone. So only Mr. Stern had great pride, personal pride in the station, and at that time, money was not a problem. You did what had to be done regardless of cost.
Do you miss the television business, Mike Lalla?
Occasionally, when there's a big storm coming, I sort of, in a way, say, thank God I'm not going, and in the other way, I sort of maybe wish I'd be there. But otherwise, not really. I'm quite satisfied in what I'm doing now.
But when we asked for a picture of himself for this story, this is the one he gave us. Mike Lala is obviously proud of his role in helping us find the road we are still traveling today. On June 27th of 1957, we sent another early news photographer, M.J. Gauthier, to Gameron, Louisiana, to await the arrival of Hurricane Audrey, which killed 500 people, more than any other storm in modern Louisiana history. To Gauthier, it was just another assignment, until he got there and tried to set up his camera, barely able to stand up as Audrey moved in.
It was very windy, very, very windy. I had to really hold the camera because it was going to blow away.
We invited Gauthier to our new studios here at Howard and Barone to look at the pictures of the storms he had covered more than 40 years ago and to let us see the pictures others took of him as he covered the news beginning in 1955, the year he joined WDSU, until he retired in 1985. He covered Hurricane Betsy, the 1965 storm that killed 68 people in New Orleans as high water flooded the area below the Industrial Canal. The only way to cover Betsy was by boat.
They're evacuating some people there, as you can see, this lady and little girl and her husband, I suppose. Just awful, you know, just see people stranded all over the place on houses and all over the place.
For the past 12 years, I have had the real honor of serving you as your mayor.
Chep Morrison was mayor of New Orleans in the 50s and 60s and died in the crash of a private plane in Mexico in 1964. WDSU was the only New Orleans station to send a reporting team to Mexico. M.J. Gauthier and this reporter. We both knew Morrison well and mourned with the rest of the audience at his funeral in Gallier Hall. And then there was Hurricane Camille, August 17, 1969, and he and Mike Lala covered this storm, one of the most powerful in history, with a wind gust in Gulfport of 239 miles an hour. His experience was similar to that of Mike Lala. Lala had trouble getting in, Gauthier had trouble getting out.
So I got stranded around somewhere around Bay St. Louis or someplace, I didn't know where I was. There was water wherever you look, like being stranded in the middle of the ocean. Which way do you go, you know, without a compass?
The camera has taken M.J. Gauthier all over the world, from the choking ash of a volcano in Costa Rica to the Great Wall of China. Now at age 78, he lives in retirement, still missing his lifelong career.
I think it was a good life. I enjoyed it very much, and I still think about it. I still wish I would be doing it.
It's high noon in the Crescent City and time to...
High noon in New Orleans, and for some 20 years, that meant it was time for Midday with Terry Flettridge. Her story in a moment when we continue with a special program on the first 50 years of Louisiana's first television station.